Hello everyone, and welcome back to some more The Long Haul with HB Gaming. We are currently in Portland. There has been an update. I don't know. Why is it messed up all of a sudden? Anyway, there has been an update. I didn't download it because it would put me back down in Fresno and it'd be all screwed up, so I'd rather just continue on and until I maybe get through some areas. I don't know why. Something's weird there, but I'll figure that out later. So, anyway, like I said, we're in Portland. Doesn't look like I've got anything going north, which kind of sucks because now I'm going to have to drive up to Seattle on my own. So, I guess that's what we shall do. Set a waypoint here. And off we go. Sometime today, at least. This kind of sucks though, because I'm wasting fuel, and at the same time not making any money. So what in the world just happened there? Why did I all of a sudden like hit reverse? Well, that was weird. I've never seen that happen before. I guess I've got a green light. Well, this is Portland. Looks an awful lot like somewhere else. I don't know exactly where, but slow it down. Being that Portland doesn't have anything like that on the outside of it, I know that for a fact, because I've been there, you know, once or twice, maybe a dozen times or more. It's green, lush. We got the Columbia River on the north side of it. We'll see if we actually go across a bridge when we do. I kind of doubt it, which kind of sucks, but it is what it is, you know. In order to get longer runs, you gotta... Did I just run a red light or a stop sign or something? But apparently not. Anyway. Leaving Portland right now. So right at this very moment, we would be on the Columbia over... or going over the a bridge that runs from Portland to Vancouver, Washington. We'd be going over the Columbia River, which is... it's fairly wide there. I don't know. I'm not exactly sure how wide it is. Maybe a half a mile? A little over a quarter mile, maybe, somewhere around there. I don't remember exactly, but... it's definitely a good-sized bridge. Yeah, we wouldn't be hitting this. That sign right there is midway across the river. As you're going across the bridge, there's a sign that sits right in the middle of the bridge up on the framework of it, you know, that says, "Welcome to Washington." So, obviously, there is no Columbia River. But, I did see, I was looking, SCS dropped some pictures talking about how they're working hard and something about how the new system they're using is guess it doesn't really say anything about it being easier, but the system they're using, they're using a new system, and they showed some pictures of the Grand Canyon and whatnot. If you haven't taken a look at it, you probably, and you're interested, I guess, but go ahead and look it up, because the pictures look nice, but still no word on when anything will drop, or so kind of disappointing. You know, it's already May. I was hoping for April. Kind of looked like April when they were saying stuff about March, but I don't know. A bit disappointing, to say the least, if it's going to take them 4 or 5 months per, I don't know, maybe they're saving it up. They'll drop Arizona, you know, because it's free, and then I can turn off my lights, I guess. They'll drop Arizona because it's free, and then, you know, maybe a month later, all of a sudden, you'll have another section of DLC that has, you know, Utah, Idaho, Oregon, and Washington, or maybe they may go straight across the southwest over into the southeast, you know, I don't know, but who knows, I'm just speculating. Personally, I don't know. I'm not a big fan of this kind of stuff that they do nowadays. The, you know, early access. You know, you go on Steam and there's freaking new early access games coming out every day, it seems like, or at least a couple times a week. Some of them are decent. Some of them are crap. The ones that are decent, it may be 6 months. And, you know, you get 2 or 3 updates and it never seems to get out of early access. And all of a sudden, they stop updating it. So, but the same sort of thing with this, you know, we get 2 states from the get-go for $20. I would rather if they just, you know, make the whole freaking map, sell it for $60, $59.99, you know, type of thing, and you can drive wherever you want. I don't know why they, you know. Now they're going to squirt out 2 or 3 maps at a time and charge you $10, you know, for each section. And by the end of it, you've spent $120 on the whole freaking U.S. or something. Well, that was quick. You know, it makes more money for them, but at the same time, it's not the way it... There's a reason why it was never done like this in the past. You know, if you bought a game on Nintendo, for crying out loud, you bought the whole game. You didn't buy one section of it. And if they, you know, Final Fantasy, there's what, 16 of them now? They just keep making them. It's not like, oh, well, I'm going to buy the first section of it and then buy the second section of it type of thing. But... anyway, I don't know. That's the way I see it, I guess. If you agree, though, give me a thumbs up, for crying out loud. Or comment, you know, one of those two. I get one person that comments just about on every... not every one of them, but, you know, most of my videos. I appreciate it. He knows who he is. And, I try to respond to them. Sometimes I don't get back. You know, I work a regular job. I own my own business, which can, you know, take up a lot of time. I try to put out a video every day. I usually will play, like, let me see what this job market looks like real quick. Hold on 1 second. I'll finish that up in a second here. Man, those are some awfully long hauls, but nothing that I really want. I try to upload every day a video. You know, I try to keep you guys entertained. But I don't always get back to the comments. And if it's, you know, 2 days or 3 days or whatever, it's not worth replying at that point. I mean, at least to me, I guess. I don't know. Maybe it is, but next up, we have Sacramento. That wouldn't be bad, because I'm going through Boise. I'm going through Jackpot, and that. Which one do I want to take, though? The BK or the Walbert? Both of them are basically the same price. This one's giving me just a smidge more, but it, you know what? I'm going to, let me check the jar market for Seattle here. Let's see what all is out there. So we got that going there. That goes straight down. I don't really want to do that. That's it, huh? Well, I'm going through Boise. I'm already here, so I didn't need to set my GPS. But anyway, what I was saying, leave a comment. Let me know, you know, even if you don't like the content that you watch, you know, if you watch it for 5 minutes and you're like, oh, this guy sucks, let me know what you know. Let me know if there's something that maybe you don't think I'm doing right or something to that effect. I would appreciate it, though. Let me know. At least some feedback would be appreciated. Or a thumbs down, you know, and then comment. Let me know. That's better than nothing. Get on the road. Got the beautiful sunset. We get those up here in Washington. Get good sunrises too, coming over the mountains. But we certainly don't have palm trees everywhere. I can tell you that. Every once in a while you'll see a palm tree. It's kind of weird. You wouldn't think they would grow up here because they're freaking, you know, it rains quite a bit. Palm trees, though, like moisture, but at the same time it never really gets, like today I think it was about 84, somewhere around there, 86. It was awfully muggy, but oh, that's interesting. Never seen that before. You know what? I could be making a mistake here. Let me check my map. Oh, okay. No, I can get to there. But it doesn't really, I mean, you know, we have during the summer up here, we've got fairly warm. I mean, you got, we may have a week's worth of weather where we're in the 90s, maybe, you know, mid 90s, high 90s sometimes. And then, you know, it'll drop back down into the 80s. So our summers are fairly mild compared to most parts of the country. And the same thing with our winters. We don't get a whole lot of snow. The mountains do. Mountains get a couple hundred inches, but it's from all the rain that falls up here. Although the rest of us don't get that much. But I think last year we had a couple days of snow, and then it went away. We did have our wettest winter on our wettest year on record, though. I don't know how many inches we had total, but from the time they were keeping records up here, last year was our wettest, and it was freaking raining all the time. I mean, normally we may get 2 or 3 days where it rains a little bit. I mean, you know, it'll rain off and on. Maybe out of the 48 hours, it may rain 35 hours or something like that, you know. But we had days up here where it was, for a week, it was nothing but rain, night and day. Get the lights on. Anyway, we've got what about almost a full day's worth of driving here. Hopefully I can make it to this rest stop. I didn't think it would be this far. Oh, yeah, I'll get there, but probably should have slept there in Seattle. This is quite the hill I'm coming up here. Now, technically, we would be going through the mountains here in about this general area on I-90. It's about, hour and a half out of Seattle. I left Seattle at about 7:30, something like that. So we're at about 2 hours. We'd be going over the Snoqualmie Pass right through here, which I think, I don't know. I don't know if he's tried to make it like that because it is kind of hilly, but I'm certainly struggling to get up to a decent speed here. I'm up to 60, but I get on the road here instead of on the shoulder. Yeah, I know. Stay awake. If I can get up to 80, I should be able to get there fairly soon, though. Going to try and get in behind that bus, but I wasn't going to be able to slow down quite fast enough. East to Montana, huh? Yeah. Stay awake. Hopefully he doesn't fall asleep going around this corner. That would be disastrous. That goes to show the physics in this game is a little off as well, because I'm going around that corner 43, 44 miles an hour. You would never be able to take a clover leaf that fast. I mean, most of the time they're warning, they got signs up that, you know, 20 to 25 miles an hour, and that's it. But it is what it is, so I'm gonna grab some fuel. And then we shall get back into the pit over there. Not sure exactly how to do it. I must go around the must have to go around. not through the scale, but I haven't had to go through a scale since I updated this to 1.2, which is kind of weird. I think I would have. But whatever. Here we go. Alright. Hey, look at the income, $36.99. That's not bad. $14.34 for Sophie. Back it on up out of here. Get back on the road. Which, this don't look right. How the heck are you supposed to? Well, yeah, you can honk all you want, but doesn't mean I'm gonna have to cut through here, I guess. I guess it's a little funky. But you gotta do what you gotta do, I guess. Let me get over after I pass these guys. Big old tubes. Come on, buddy, speed up. And Steve comes in last there. He came in second, I should say. Sophie came in last, but he was the last to report his income there, at least. So we're back on the road. Got 800 miles to go. We got a full tank of fuel. And 20 hours ahead of us. This might be a little longer episode, I'm thinking. Clear skies, though, a little cloud cover, but 75 degrees, that's not bad, huh? That's tolerable. At least they got that right. I mean, we're in eastern Washington, or down, well, let's see. Well, we're on 80, so we're in Oregon now, I believe. We skipped over into Oregon. And which will put us. We'll be moving into Idaho here shortly. Oh no, there's 84, so that's Oregon. Highway 84 runs along the border on the Oregon side between Washington and Oregon. Family station wagon there. Oh, Nelly. Coming up onto some traffic here. Hopefully they all behave themselves and don't try and pull in front of me. Just what I wanted. Yeah, we got the pedal to the metal here and almost doing 80. So far the scenery is incorrect as well. Eastern Washington looks more like, well, not like this. Let's just say that, I guess. It's more open plains, I guess you would say. It's rolling hills, but there's not a whole lot of trees over there. It's pretty arid, so apparently the guy didn't look at any pictures of it. The only thing I can figure. Got a little screw up right there in the overall, though it's not bad. It's, you know, I mean, I can't complain too much. The guy, it looks more like this over there for the most part. You get some green, but it's from farms more than anything. All irrigation, because it's not like that naturally. So we need to drop off Wednesday, or we are dropping off Wednesday, I should say, and it's between 8 and Thursday at noon. No, 12:34 a.m., so that's in the morning. Loan installment there. So if I sleep again, that's going to put us at about, just past noon when we're actually going to get there. I got to find a rest stop. There. Certainly not going to stop there. I can't zoom out any farther. So, we're winging it. I don't plan on checking the map. I'm sure there's going to be one. There's got to be. Otherwise, I'm going to have to drive straight through, I guess. Got about 9.5 hours left of driving before I have to go to sleep. I'm not quite sure why they made it that way, though. You know, in real life, you see, not very often, but I see trucks, you know, they won't be parked on the side of the freeway, but they'll be parked on a side road off from in a city, or, you know, I've seen trucks parked on city streets, or they'll find a, you know, a Walmart or whatever kind of store you want to, shopping center or whatever. And park there for the night. And so I don't know why they don't allow that in this game. It would be nice if they did. It'd make a little more sense, you know. You could, I mean, I guess it's a little harder this way, but not very realistic. There was a cop on the other side. I'm doing 88 miles an hour, and I was doing about 86 when I passed him. So either they can't see to this side, because normally that would be a ticket on my part. Oh, there's, Well, I'm not going to be sleeping there either. 90, 91. We are hauling. Heck, if I can do that fast the whole time, which obviously I'm not, but if I could, I would be there pretty fast. Wouldn't have to worry about going to sleep, I don't think. Come on, get off the rumble strip there. I'd like to get past this Jeep. He's kind of screwing me. Maybe he'll move over on me. Or for me, I should say. That's one thing. I don't know. You know, you drive through most states. I don't know how it is. Midwest, back east. But most of the states around here, you go down to Oregon. Most people, Idaho, they'll, you know, they sit in the fast lane here. Just like this guy. He, you know, he finally moved over. But they'll, well, what the heck. They'll sit in the fast lane and just putt along. You know, here in Washington, I mean, there is no, you don't, they're starting to crack down on it, because I think ambulances and stuff like that are starting to have a hard time getting through traffic, because these guys will sit in the fast lane doing 60 miles an hour. The speed limit's 60, right? They'll be at 60 or 59 or, you know, right around there, and they'll just sit there, drive along, you know. You can be right on their tail. They won't freaking move over for you for nothing. Boise discovered. Now I can take trips out of there at least. It's good that you don't have to go into the city itself. But, you know, they're not courteous whatsoever. You can, I mean, you'll come up on them doing 65, 68, because, you know, when it's light traffic, you can do that speed and drive right by a cop, and they won't try and stop you or anything. You know, they don't. You're maintaining a safe speed. You know, you're up at 75, they'll pull you over or whatever, but you're maintaining a safe speed. Then, you know, as long as it's not, like I said, heavy traffic or raining out or something like that, they don't really care. Man, I need to get past the semis. But you'll come up on these guys, and like I said, just putting along. They have a fair amount of incidences of road rage up here, and that's probably why. You got these people that, I don't know, for whatever reason, either they have the attitude that, you know, you shouldn't be going faster than 60 miles an hour, or I don't know, who knows what the deal is with them, but you run into that a lot up in Washington. Whereas, you know, when I've driven down in Oregon, you move over into the fast lane, you pass a couple people, you move back over, same thing, you know, happens to you. Somebody passes you, they move back over in front of you, you know, no problems. But for some reason up here, it can be frustrating sometimes. Nice Camaro. Is that a Firebird? That's a Firebird. No, that... Well, now I can't really see the taillights all that well, but... Actually, I think that was a Firebird, but... Either or. I BMW. Now I've got clear skies. They need to add some more cars to this thing. I don't know, they need to add a lot of things into this. I don't know, I'm not sure how big their team is though, to be honest with you. I need to move over. Oh, he's moving over. Nice. Anyway, it would be nice to have a little more content in the game, considering they I don't know. It would just be nice to see a little bit more, because it's getting a bit old. Oh, I'm 65. Seeing the same cars every time, or I mean, imagine if I didn't have any downloads, you know, no mods installed at all. Same 15 cars over and over again, same, you know, stretch of highway in between San Francisco and Reno and then down to Las Vegas, and it would just seem to get boring. I wouldn't want to watch that over and over again if there wasn't something changing. This is kind of interesting. Nothing on the side here at all. A couple trees over there. Got some telephone poles. Or electrical poles, whatever you want to call them. In jackpot. So realistically, I might be able to make it 11:23. I'm gonna try and push it. What the heck? Why not? Because unless I go past a rest stop right when I need to go to sleep, I'm just gonna push on through. You can usually go about an hour past red. From what I've seen, especially if I can catch lights and you know, don't hit any traffic or anything like that. I thought this was going to take a lot longer than it did though. I don't know if the compression is different up there. I'm only at about 40 minutes of time, and and that was driving up from Portland to Seattle. So something is amiss. Because normally, 600-700 miles is about this amount of time. 800 miles, somewhere around there. And you figure Portland to Seattle is about 170 miles, somewhere around there. So that alone, is about what we have left in this trip, and it's 4 hours or so in game. And I don't think it's going to take, or I should say, I don't think it took as long as this is going to take. But I could be wrong, I don't know. Kick my lights on so I don't get a fine for that. Doing 67, just a hair over. Let me get it back. Oh, there's a sign for 55. There's a sign for 35. That's the new MHAPro did that. He put in like staggered to let you know when it was kind of slowing down, which is nice. You know, rather than all of a sudden type of deal. And I think you can see those signs a little easier too. Come on, get up to speed here. There's the BP. I added back into the game there the real names of gas stations. Just because I was tired of seeing the other ones. And it didn't affect the map any, so I didn't have to restart myself. I will probably, maybe in the next episode, put in the map update, because now that I'm down south here, it's not going to really make a whole lot of difference. But I don't know, maybe not. Because I think from Eli I can go east. Out highway. I'm not sure what it is. Oh, no, it's from highway 80 up north of me there. But that's fine too, that's no big deal. I can go on that little windy road that's just to the, from the junction with 93 and 80 there. Whatever that is. And we'll be able to check out the coast-to-coast map then. See how good that is. Be nice if these guys... I'm gonna pass them. Screw it. Probably shouldn't, but I'm gonna try it at least. That guy's pressing on his brakes up here. I don't know what his problem is, but oh, there's a semi on the side of the road. So if the AI can do it, why can't I? That's the question I've got for you. See, now I've seen that before. Doesn't make any sense. Who knows, maybe they'll change that eventually. Hopefully they do, because that's kind of ridiculous. There's a rest area right there, but it's only 9 o'clock. I'm not even in the red yet, so we got a little over an hour. I can easily make it. Which is also the weird thing, because if I remember right, the time it was supposed to take me to drive that distance was like 23 hours. And I rested before I picked up the load. If I remember, or no, I didn't. I rested after I picked up the load. So I guess, well, it was like 20 hours left until I had to rest after I had rested. So, yeah, the compression up there must be different somehow. Something's not right with that. But here's McGill. This is a new town. Let's get down to a reasonable speed here. Whoop, now it drops from 35 to 30. This is nice looking. See, it'd be nice if the guy that does the MHAPro maybe he's working on it, I don't know, would do more, because he adds in stuff like that. He added that destination in there, or the city. Great. A short one. They're always short though, I think. That's kind of cool. Got that train sitting there on the side. Kind of neat looking. Running out of fuel. I got plenty of fuel. Only got 4 miles to go here. That truck that I passed earlier. And there's my destination up on the right, so getting very sleepy. Trying to hypnotize me. Well, another successful delivery without a ticket. Even though I was speeding for a good portion of it. Don't know. I'm okay with that. Sometimes you get caught, sometimes you don't. Safe. Oh, I was reading the sign. Well, I spoke too soon. I probably should have locked up my trailer or something. Try and stop that, but looks like you guys probably, if you're from the Northwest, you'd know what I'm talking about. Taco time. It's kind of like a Taco Bell, but a lot better. I'm pretty sure it's only Oregon, Washington, and Idaho is where it's located, just the Northwest. But pretty good food, actually. And when I say a lot better than Taco Bell, I mean a lot better than Taco Bell. And it actually tastes like meat. Got the Burger King. Okay. Oh, what the heck? Where am I supposed to drop off here? I saw that green and I was like, oh, it's right. Well, it is here. Okay. I didn't see that green. I hope it's not right in here somewhere. I guess I can get gas. It's kind of interesting. I hope nobody's coming because I can't see behind. Good. In the back. Oh boy. I may have gone a little too far with it, but we shall see. Yep, I might be able to correct this just enough. Probably not though. I don't know if that's going to give it to me or not. Kind of doubt it. Don't look like it. But that's better. There we go. Alrighty. 984 miles driven. Not too bad. Not too shabby. Ended up making $20,286 and 1,189 experience. That's pretty good there. I like that. Urgent delivery bonus. Got that. Long distance bonus. Got that. And of course the bonus for parking the trailer. So we are currently level 11 and that is where my next point is going, because I'm going to get that. So I'm going to go fill up some fuel here since I'm getting low. Getting very sleepy. Good sound effects there. I like that. Anyway, I appreciate you guys hanging out and watching a little bit of the long haul. Leave a comment, leave a like, subscribe if you want to see more, and we shall see you next time. Have a good one.